Hi guys, it's Spectre Gaming. Welcome back to some more In Sound Mind. This is part 7. I kind of got a little bit stuck with this one. I did find a fuse over on the right hand side, and there's no way through on the left. So there's got to be something over there that I've missed. I don't know where. So I need to have a little look around and see what I can find. Weren't this thing open last time? Shit. Okay. So... Oh, them flares are gone. Fuck. Right, there's gotta be... Last time those boxes weren't there. So he must have pulled the boxes into the ground or something, I don't know. Oh, I can jump that. Fuck me. Wow. Oh, what? That's pretty cool. Did you pull this down, dumbass? Well, it's... Looks like a girder, but... He's putting a bit further. Concrete show. Oh! And I jumped on that fucking lorry last time and I couldn't see shit. If I can see up with this. There he is, there's Psycho Allen. He's on the other side of the warehouse. Fucking ring. Please work, please open. Oh. Ha 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 ha. Oh. Due to the mishandling of the shipment, we have to contain as much as we can focus on damage control. We still don't have the clear up of traffic not a minute after leaving with this. While comfortable with these stock workers, local hires handling stuff. Okay. Where's Psycho gone to? Never mind. Fuck that. Fuck off. What I want you to show me is you fucking off somewhere. Stop camping this goddamn corner. There's gotta be somewhere else you can fucking go. I don't wanna be afraid anymore. I don't care what you wanna be. I want you to be somewhere else. I don't get what I fucking want, apparently. There's no there, okay. Fuse, is that all three? Three fuses. Oh. Oh, fuck me. So, oh, it means this ventilation shaft. No, oh, so I've got to beat him over there to go and pull that box down. Box. Shit. Might be a bit far to run, maybe. Whoa.
It's a fuse box.
Okay. balls. Ugh, fuck. No, no! I'm in the light, fuck off! Bastard.
It's blocked from the other side.
He's camping that fucking area. What the hell that leads to? Count note was in that thing, though, I'll be honest. What the fuck?
Bravo! It only took you an hour to find your way past a chain link fence. That light you've been carrying around seems to be losing its brightness. Perhaps like you, it needs to be put in its place.
Not bad.
Oh shit! Gun throwing things. Ah. Fucking hell. Fuck. Oh, damn. She's not even seeping anymore under that. Shit.
Not working.
When I was in high school, I used to hide in dark room. Like Insanity, alright. Had a nightmare where I went to that new superstore. A lady with blood coming out of her neck threw glass at me. Might not have been dreaming, it's unclear, I haven't slept in 3 days. Poor little kid sounds like we're fucking traumatized.
Waking up in cold sweat, being haunted by government spies, and loving it is not normal. Neither is losing your patience. Paranoia will eat you whole, won't it?
Maybe. So he's not actually dead then, this guy. He's in by Sandra, some sort of coma or something. I can pick up the TV on, alright, okay.
The door is all worth a try. No luck.
Thank you. that guy sounded a little bit flustered. Maybe I'm onto something. He wants me to, but I can hear the tone in his voice where he's secretly hoping, please don't do it, sort of thing. What the fuck? What the hell were the flares for then?
To shed some light. Of course, no power.
Got 15 fucking health.
Not bad.
Shit. Yes. Fuck. How do I... How do I get in there? I had to use everything I had. Fight that fucking gigantic lantern at the top of the fucking lighthouse.
You're braver than you know. Alan's madness came on just as suddenly as Virginia's did. I have no doubt their cases are linked. I need to follow the chemical trail, see where it takes me.
So this chemical matter drove his patients insane, and where Alan's in a coma and not dead, Virginia committed suicide. So it looks like you're saving your patients then. And then in return of saving your patients, you might also end up saving or redeeming yourself in some capacity. I still think it's overly harsh to put the blame on a psychologist. I mean, he's there to try and help the patients. Whether they think he or she's doing good or not, they're not there doing some selfish thing. It's their job, it's a selfless act. They're there to help the patients out. And I imagine that the psychologists probably feel they failed in, to some degree, worse than most if a patient does kill themselves. Because basically it's like they failed their job into really.
You're back. Good. I was getting worried. Things are starting to become unstable around here.
How so?
The ground is shaking and the water outside is rising.
I know what happened to Alan.
I know. I saw. Alan mentioned that driver you were treating. Max Nygaard. Classic bag of cats, that guy. There's probably a door to his house here as well.
Yeah, I was thinking the same thing.
Okay, that's just saved. There's another book here. Ah, so I clicked in books as well on that shelf.
I hope you've noticed those chemical barrels are explosive. Just saying.
Yep. Right, okay. I'm going to leave this part here. This is Alan's part concluded. So, looks like we've got two more patients to do. Next one is a guy called Nygaard. And then probably one more patient after him. And then if there is another tape that resides here, it's probably going to be another one of ours, I'm guessing. I'm going to guess.
Even after all of this, I still can't imagine.
Also, we've got two more books to close. So, I hope you guys are enjoying the series so far. Give me a like if you enjoyed the video. If you're new around here, drop me a subscription. It's free, helps grow the channel. I really appreciate it. Leave me a comment down below if you want, and I'll get back to you. And all my links are in the description below as well. Take care, everyone, and have a great day.